In the previous videos, we read about the structure of a cell. Clear? Structure of a cell we read. I told you this cell is just bound by a membrane. Do you remember the name of this membrane? Yes. Yes, it's cell membrane. Membrane of the cell is cell membrane. I told you membrane is a skin-like structure. I gave you two functions. First function is it packs all materials together of the cell. And second thing is this is working like a watchman, and it allows or disallows the entry or exit of substances from the cell or into the cell. Right? This cell membrane. The second thing that I told you, that inside this cell membrane, all this place this is occupied by a semi-liquid substance. Do you remember the name I told? A semi-liquid substance or plasm. So plasm of the cell is called cytoplasm or cell plasm. Cyto means of the cell. Cytoplasm or cell plasma. You see the last two letters, ma. As we call our mother ma, so as our mother behaves, if you are hungry, you get food from your mother. If you are hurt, who gives you the first aid? Your mother gives. When you cry or in pain, who soothes you? Your mother comes. Similarly, this cytoplasm, you must remember, or cell plasma, this cell plasma is a source of all the requirements of all different living parts of the cell. Whatever they need, they get from the cytoplasm. If they are hurt, who will repair their injuries? The cytoplasm. If they are hungry, who will avail them the food? The cytoplasm. Right? And if they want to rest, they will rest in the lap of their mother, right? So all different part. Clear? So cell membrane is one of the very important part that keeps all the cell parts together, right? And works like a watchman, a security person that allows or disallows the entry and exit of substances. Second is cytoplasm or semi-liquid substance that is rich in nutrients. The cytoplasm is rich in nutrients. Nutrients means the substances that are required to nourish a living body. So cytoplasm is source of all the materials that are required by this living parts of the cell. Next very important structure of the cell, I will come here. There is another small spherical or oval. Again, a structure that is surrounded by a small membrane. As you see here, cell membrane. So, name of this structure is nucleus. Nucleus. Hence, this, as the name of this structure is nucleus, but this nucleus also is surrounded by a membrane. As you see, cell is surrounded or packed in a membrane. This materials of the nucleus is also packed in a membrane. And the name of this membrane is nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane. Right? Remember. And this is very important part of a cell. Here I must tell you one thing, that even if all other parts, living parts are present in the cell will not be treated as a living cell unless you notice this structure, that is nucleus, right? So here you must remember, a cell without a nucleus is a dead cell. So to make this cell to keep this cell in a living state, this structure that is known as the nucleus must remain present. So this nucleus is either spherical like a ball or oval like an egg shaped. Clear? This also packs semi-liquid substances as the cell packed inside this, and this is called nucleoplasm. Or nucleus plasma, ma. When the word ma, same again. As the cytoplasm behave for all other components inside the cell, say for this nucleus, similarly this nucleoplasm behave exactly in the same way for other materials present inside this nucleus, and is a source of all to meet all requirements of the components of this nucleus. We have the nucleoplasm. It is also a semi-liquid substance and rich in nutrients. So this provides all. In this, bits of thread-like structures in pairs remain present. Actually, these structures, they come together, and these structures are known as the chromosomes. When in biology we write the body SOMES, it is not some as in English. It is SOMES we read. Chromosomes, SOMES means body parts or living body parts, right? So chromosomes are the living body parts. These are very minute structures, means in at the level of angstrom it may go. The size may go at the level of 10 to the power minus 10 meter, right? So these chromosomes are thread-like structures. These thread-like structures actually are, I am separately drawing this. You see this way. So many dotted structures, dot-like structures, they come together in a column. And they give appearance. These dotted, small dotted structures are called as chromatin. C-H-R-O-M-A-T-I-N. And this whole structure is chromosome. Right. This chromosome, what is this chromosome? I am talking of that. To that extent. Why? What is the reason? Actually, this is like the memory card of your mobile. You use memory cards? 32 GB memory card, 64 GB, then that memory of some of your computers are in terabytes, TB, is it? So these are the memory cards, and in these memory cards, all the detail feature of the parent are packed, ready to be transferred. You know, you store the data in your memory cards and you just put the same memory card in some other phone or other computer or laptop, you get all the information that is stored in that memory card. Similarly, these chromosomes are the memory cards, right? And these memory cards, they contain or they retain all the information. What will be the shape of your nose tip? Or what will be the color of your skin? What will be the color of your eyes? What will be the color of your hairs? What shape your fingers will have? What type of voice you will have? What type of lips you will have? All this information that remain packed inside this chromosome. See the sophisticated work of nature, Mother Nature. It's not so simple. It's a very complicated job done by Mother Nature to create the human beings or the natural living beings. So these chromosomes, they are made up of chromatin fibers, and these together make this structure chromosome, and this is a storehouse or store place for the features, characters and informations of a particular living being, right? And during the reproduction, when this living being, suppose this is the cell I am studying of Mr. A, right? I am studying this cell from the body of Mr. A. So all these features that Mr. A possesses are stored in this, and at the time of reproduction, when this Mr. A will produce children, say Mr. Master B and Master C is produced, so this feature of Mr. A will be transferred to B and will be transferred to C through these chromosomes, right? So chromosome is also the hereditary material, and these are the you can say the socket for keeping the information, right? And this chromatin is holding very small structures known as genes. These genes, they are the smaller units of this storing or GB cards, memory cards, right? And if you may have visited the maternities or hospital where new infants are born, you may have seen the relatives talk about the small babies and say, oh my god, the nose is resembling the mother. When they see the baby, they say, oh, the forehead is resembling the maternal aunt. Oh my god, the leg is resembling. So how this resemblance from the parents came come? You may have visited your relative in summer vacation after long many years, and seeing you, they may say, oh, this one is the child, this one is the son of so and so, right? Oh, this is Raju's son, this is Mr. Ramesh's son, like that. This how it is, because we resemble, we look like our parents, right? So how we get these features from our parents? Through these chromosomes. These chromosomes, they have the genes are small packets of the information from the parents of the feature, right? So these are transferred during the process of reproduction. Then this, in the first lesson I have told you about pollination and fertilization. Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains contain the male cell, and in the flowers ovary, you have seen the ovules containing the female cell, and they united, they fused together and made the zygote that resulted in the formation of seed further. So this zygote is formed by the union of, or the seed is formed by the union of pollen grain as pollen cell as well as the ovule cell. Pollen cell is the male cell, ovule cell is the female. Similarly, we get these features, these cells, they combine together and result the offspring, and in that offspring, the characters are transferred through these chromosomes and genes. So this nucleus is the very important part of the cell that contains this chromatin material or chromosomes, and these chromosomes, they help in the transfer of features or characters from the parents to the offsprings. Along with these chromosomes, some spherical bodies are also present, one or two in number. These spherical bodies are known as nucleolus. These are the small bodies similar to the nucleus, right? These are also very important structures inside the nucleus. Clear? So now regarding the function of the nucleus, when we talked, and this nucleus is made in this way, but this nucleus function is very important. I told you a cell without a nucleus is dead cell, means a nucleus has many important function. Nucleus has many important functions to carry on. For the first thing, all activities inside this, as I have told you, so many living organelles or living parts remain suspended inside the cytoplasm. One among them is this nucleus. Nucleus is the master one, is the head of those, right? It's like the brain. As our brain directs us to perform an activity, similarly this nucleus directs all other parts of the cell to perform or carry on different activities. So see, all the activities of the cell are carried out with the direction of the nucleus. Second, it helps in the cell division. It helps in the transfer of characters from parents to offspring. Transfer of characters and features from parents to offspring. Right? So all activities inside the cell are controlled or regulated by all the activities of cell. Controlled and regulated by nucleus. It helps in cell division. Means cell division is the process that helps to multiply the number of the cell. Right? And later on I will tell you here one structure is present that initiates the cell division. Right? So cell division, transfer of characters from parents to this way, this whole nucleus work. You can say in a simple way, nucleus is the brain. Is the brain of the cell. Right? So this is all about the third part of the third structure of the cell. Important structure. Thank you.